Oh, the glory is here. The glory is here. Well, I'm Pastor George Pearsons, and I welcome you to Miracles on the Mountain. So glad that you are here. Let me ask, first of all, for those that are here in the building, how many of you, this is your very first time? Let me see. Whoa, look at all the hands that have gone up. Thank you for being here. Thank you for coming to be with us. What a thrill it is. And those of you who are here for the first time, there's a guest card in the seat in front of you. If you fill that out, and you can put it in the basket as we receive the offering in a few minutes, or you can take it to the Connect Station registration out in the lobby. We have a gift that we want to bless you with. Thank you for coming. Thank you for adding your supply to this meeting that we're having here today. And we've jumped off the edge. We are in the realm of faith. We have stepped off. And we are going to see some magnificent things take place. I also want to welcome everyone that is watching us from the top of the world to the bottom, all the way around. Give them a great hand. So good to see you. So good to have you with us. And specifically, we have people that, and of course, we're on the network, we're on Facebook, we're on all of the outreaches, literally, of Kenneth Copeland Ministries. But we do know where some people are watching us from, and I do want to welcome especially those from Canada, Germany, India, Barbados, the United Kingdom, Singapore, Slovenia, Trinidad and Tobago, Brazil, France, the Bahamas, and of course the United States of America. So welcome all of them that are watching us right now. Praise God. Isn't this exciting? Isn't this exciting to be together and to know that we're stepping into a place with the Lord that we've never been before? A place in Him that we've never seen before. Well, before we get into the message, it's offering time. Are you excited about offering time today? Let me hear it stronger. It's offering time. Praise God. Open your Bibles to Luke chapter 6. Luke chapter 6. And I want to talk to you for a few moments about what to expect when you give. You need to be expecting. There needs to be a high expectation. Every time you sow seed in an offering, there needs to be an expectation of exactly what is going to happen where that seed is concerned. It just doesn't disappear somewhere in space. It goes down into the good ground of the Word of God, and it begins to work, it begins to grow, and it begins to what? Produce fruit. It produces fruit in your life. Your sowing produces fruit. How many of you have been faithful tithers and sowers for a long time? Let me see your hand. Wave at me. Wave at me. Well, you need to have such an expectation of what God is going to do and produce in your life. And I want to take a look at a scripture here, Luke 6:38. We've read it before, but boy, we need to read it again with a sense of what God wants to do. It says, "Give, and it shall be given unto you." Now let's stop right there for just a moment. It says, "Give, and what? It shall," or you can say it like this, "It will be given to you." Say, "Give," say, "Give, and it will be given to me." It says, "Good measure, pressed down, shaken together, and running over, shall men give into your bosom." Now it goes on to say here, for with the same measure that you meet or you give with all, it shall be measured back to you again. And I was doing some study in this scripture and really delving into it and asking me the Lord to show me some things about it. Because I really, even though you've heard a scripture a number of times before, you don't want to inoculate yourself against the truth, the new truth that the Lord wants to bring out in it. So I have a couple of things here. When it says, "Given it shall be given unto you," good measure. Now I looked up that word good measure. I did some study in the Greek about that. And you know that word good measure, or that phrase, good measure, it means surpassing. Surpassing. It means beyond, and it means overflow. Good measure means surpassing. What does that mean? It's a surpassing harvest. It is, if you will, like the sign says above me here, an abundant harvest. Did you know that this is the year of the abundant harvest? Did you realize that? That we are in the time of the abundant harvest? Well, it says it will be given to us, say, given to me, and it'll be given to me with good measure. That means a surpassing. That means beyond. It means beyond measure, the ability to be able to calculate. The Lord wants to overwhelm you with His goodness. He wants to absolutely overwhelm you to where you have not just enough to pay for the needs that you have, but He wants to see to it that you have far beyond, that there is a surplus of prosperity in your life. Well, He said, good measure, then it's pressed down, it's shaken together, and then running over. Running over, that's abundance. Say, my cup runs over. Everywhere I go. When I looked at this phrase, running over, it's very interesting. I'll put it up on the screen for you. It means to pour out in such a surpassing and overwhelming overflow of harvest that it is exceeding abundantly beyond measure and so huge that it cannot be counted and it's impossible to be contained. Now that is a mouthful for that, just those two words running over. To pour out such a surpassing and overwhelming overflow of harvest that it is exceeding abundantly beyond measure, the ability to count, and so huge that it cannot be counted and it's impossible to be contained. That is a picture. That's a picture of the kind of return that God wants to get back into our lives. I was reading from the Passion Translation. How many of you read from the Passion Translation? What a wonderful translation that is. That same scripture says, give generously and generous gifts will be given back to you, shaken down to make room for more. Abundant gifts will pour out upon you with such an overflowing measure that it will run over the top. Your measurement of generosity becomes the measurement of your return. So in this scripture, it's giving us a picture. There's going to be so much, it has to be shaken down in order to make room for more. You've got to have a picture of that. You have to see that because that's the way God sees us. Every time we sow seed into the kingdom of God, that's the way He sees us. And so it tells us that abundant gifts will pour out upon you with such an overflowing measure that it will run over the top. See, that's what's happening to you right now. Do you receive that? Do you take that? Do you take hold of that? And it's so huge, it cannot be counted. It's just like Joseph when he went out into the fields to count the grain for Pharaoh. And he was trying to keep track of how much grain there was, and it got to such a place where he couldn't keep track of it anymore. It said he quit counting. He quit counting because it was so much. I believe that we're living in the time of the abundance. We're standing in the time of abundant miracles. Prosperity miracles. I know every one of us here at Kenneth Copeland Ministries, Eagle Mountain Church, Kenneth Copeland Bible College, we have a lot to do and a lot to get done. We're talking about millions to get done. The things that need to be done and the outreaches that need to take place. But we are in a place where believing God, we're using our faith, and we are sowing our seed. Sowing our seed and believing for this scripture right here. I'll just read this to you. It tells us in 2 Corinthians 9:8 in the Amplified, we're talking about what to expect when you give. Well, expect this. God is able to make all grace, say all grace, every favor, an earthly blessing. And it says not just to come to you in a little bit, it says come to you in abundance. In abundance. So that you may always and under all circumstances and whatever the need be self-sufficient, possessing enough to require no aid or support, and I love this phrase, furnished in abundance. Say it three times. Furnished in abundance. Say, I'm furnished in abundance. I'm furnished in abundance. Say it one more time. I'm furnished in abundance for every good work and charitable donation. So what do we expect when we give? We expect that God will give unto us good measure, surpassing measure, pressed down, shaken together, running over, shall men give into our bosom. To see that supernatural abundance in their lives and in our lives. So I pray over you today. And I pray over your giving, both here and those that are watching us. and believe in the name of Jesus that you are walking in a place of abundant harvest, that you've stepped into this meeting. You've stepped under this covering of this anointing. And there's going to be a lot that'll take place. I'll tell you something. If you're a partner with Kenneth Copeland Ministries, you partake of every benefit of this ministry. 2 years ago, the Lord spoke to me and said, and this was real helpful to me as the CEO, that He said, you'll get more done in this ministry in 1 year than you have in 20. Amen. And it's happening. It's happening. Things are happening faster and faster and faster. There is a supernatural acceleration that is on us. We're getting more done in less time than we ever have before. If you calculate it out, we're getting 20 days of work done in every 1 day. Every 1 day. It's a supernatural thing. And what we're talking about here in our giving, it's a supernatural thing that takes place. I'm declaring over you every bill paid, every debt wiped out, every need met with much left over. Your days of living paycheck to paycheck are over forever. They're over forever. And you're building great reserves to be able to be used for whatever you need and to be used for the kingdom of God. So I want us to do this. Before we give, I want you to stand up. Stand up, and we're going to make a declaration of faith. We're going to speak the word of God over our lives, over the miraculous in the provisionary realm of God. And I want you to say this, and I want you to use your faith. I want you to believe God over this. Say this after me. As I give today, it will be given to me a surpassing measure that will be spilling over. I am furnished in abundance. I am blessed beyond measure. I have more than enough. My cup is running over. I give, and it will be given back to me. Good measure. Pressed down. Shaken together. And running. I receive it. I'm living in the overflow. Come on, give God praise for all of that. Thank you, Jesus. Go ahead and be seated. If you'd like an envelope, there's one in the seat in front of you. If you're writing out a check, you can make it payable to EMIC. And those of you that are watching us online, you can go to emic.org/give and then click on to Miracles on the Mountain. Also, text to give 36609. And then EMIC event, and then the dollar amount. And that information is on the screen for you. How grateful I am to the Lord that you are here and that you are here. We are going to see the power of God in action. Amen. Amen. Amen.